Paul Milgram, there are so many pluses and negatives about cryptocurrencies. How should an average person understand and assess the role of these cryptocurrencies in savings and investment decisions that every household takes? You know, the economy of countries across the world are diving downwards, but the stock market is shooting up and Bitcoin is rocketing. It's like the Russian Sputnik vaccine.
See, it's a rocket ship, yeah.
Explain that.
Well, so you're talking specifically about Bitcoin mostly, I think, and which has, you know, 10 years ago was what, $25, and now what's $50,000, $60,000. I haven't looked in the last few days. I mean, it's just incredible what's happened to the values. And it's also very hard to grapple with because I think that there's a lot of risk associated with it. People are investing in blockchain because it has some unique attributes, very easy to transact. It can't be easily, the government can't confiscate it from you. The people who are worried about that like to invest in it. It provides a hedge against monetary inflation when governments are doing their monetary. All those things are reasons to invest, and yet it would seem so easy to create substitutes. There are other cryptocurrencies that people are creating, and if they catch on, then why would you put your money in blockchain, which is so expensive? What is the foundation for the value? It's a kind of fiat currency. It's something that's valuable only because other people say it's valuable. It doesn't have any inherent value of its own. So we'll see. I think one of the things that's driving blockchain up is the fear of missing out. That people are thinking, you know, my God, it's shooting up. I should get some, you know, just in case it continues to go up. And the demand is feeding on itself. But that's bubble type demand. It could collapse again if people back away from that.
Yeah. Yep. FOMO, the fear of missing out.
FOMO, yes. Fear of missing out. FOMO.
So what would you advise an average person to do? Invest in Bitcoin or not? Number one. And number two, what would you advise a government, say like the Indian government, should governments allow Bitcoin, blockchain freely or try and have tight controls and ban it?
So I think tight controls are pretty much impossible. I think that one of the appeals of blockchain, one of the reasons people invest in it, is they think that it's very, very hard for you have your wallet, your blockchain wallet, your secret passwords. Nobody can see what you're doing. And without blocking access to the whole internet, it's just very hard to control blockchain. For the average person, you know, I wouldn't put too much, you know, I think that there is this FOMO thing. People have some fear of missing out. But I think investing in it too much in it is extremely risky. I think we're talking about it really looks like a bubble to me right now. And bubbles eventually break. People make money during bubbles too, and if you have that fear of missing out and you want to invest a little bit, but don't overdo, because you could have your whole asset wiped out. We see the same thing with the GameStop, you know, the GameStop of shares that also, you know, we had just a bunch of people who decided they were going to drive it up, and they did, and so a lot of people made a lot of money. A lot of people are going to lose a lot of money too, is the way it's going to happen.